It would be very impolite to talk about music and not to talk about passion. So we'll talk about passion for a little bit. I, not long ago, was in Dunkin' Donuts. And I witnessed a little fight. It was not very dramatic, but as a result of it, one lady threw a paper cup on the floor. But it was, as I say, it was just a paper cup with very little water, so no big damage was done. So I actually could enjoy what was going on. And I was amazed by the gesture she made when she was throwing up. It was this wonderful, free gesture, not restricted. And I thought, well, this is wonderful. This is what passion can make us do, make this wonderful, unrestricted gesture. Well, passion and romanticism kind of started and go together. Let's try to imagine that we in the middle of 19th century in France. At the time, people, especially ladies, really didn't do lots of sports. It was not the thing to do. So the best way they could exercise I would be fainting at the concert. It was a very common thing to faint at the concert, and the performers also fainted. Just because the music was so passionate and dramatic. I'll play one of these pieces. I don't hope for the results, but we'll try our best. It's Chopin's second ballad, F major. And this is from this ballad that I played the piece in the very beginning, if you remember, I'll remind you. When hands absolutely disregard each other. Now listen, please, what happens when they play together and when you can't really focus on what each of them is doing.
Thank you. Now that's what happens when passion is exaggerated. Now let's listen what happens when passion is not exaggerated. When drama just happens to be drama without people making bigger gestures about it. This is Mozart. It's A minor sonata. Mozart didn't write in minor. He only wrote two minor sonatas. It would be always happy, major. So let's listen how drama changes.
Thank you.
No, I think, just like I believe love is elusive, I think talking about it also should be a little bit. So we're going to have a musical break. I'll play with something which has nothing to do with passion, with love, with seduction, just a little prelude of Bach. And you can think whatever you think. Fun, he has fun.